In 2010, an informant told the ATF about a gang of white supremacists selling stolen weapons and drugs in Omaha, Nebraska. An undercover agent was detailed to infiltrate this notorious hate group in order to halt this illegal sale of guns. The deep undercover investigation was called Operation Red Swastika.
The confidential informant introduced myself and a state and local undercover to Jason Hawthorne, who we called Skin, or who he called himself Skin.
Posing as an arms trafficker, the undercover agent met Skin at a local bar to talk about purchasing weapons. Skin was also a member of the Church of the Creator. He also commanded a destructive gang of convicted criminals, said to have strong ties to United Aryan soldiers and neo-Nazis.
The four or five guys that were in there were dressed in their red suspenders, which is some kind of sign for their unity.
Skin was a twice convicted criminal and was earning good money selling illegal guns to criminals, gangs, and whoever met his price.
He knew that I was interested in guns, that I was a trafficker, and we talked about the machine guns that he was willing to sell to us. Their primary agenda was money.
Convinced that the undercover ATF agent was an illegal weapons dealer, Skin agreed to do business. They set up a second meeting for high-powered weapons and crystal meth.
First thing I saw when I walked into Jason Hawthorne's apartment was a red swastika flag. He was very proud of that flag. It was his centerpiece of his apartment. We're waiting for one of his crew, Michael Davis Smiley, to also negotiate a price.
Ooh, well, those two are real good guns. I can unload those. These here are more hunting rifles, but like I can make money off those. It's more like eight to a thousand.
I purchased seven stolen firearms and over 5,000 rounds of ammunition.
The undercover agent had gained Skin's trust. A second sale was quickly arranged for the following week. This time, the location was in Skin's car.
For him, my credibility was the money in my pocket. He liked the amount of money I was paying for the firearms, the amount of money that I was paying for the methamphetamine.
All right. Cool. Hell yeah.
Over the next several weeks, there were more weapon and drug sales. But Skim became increasingly nervous and paranoid. He constantly monitored a police scanner. Then he revealed an even more nefarious plot to the agent.
One of my buddies is looking for something. I'm going to get him out of jail.
Skin confided in the agent about a plot to blow up the county jail.
I'm just going to take out the wall right there by the window. Okay, on the first floor.
But it got worse. He asked the agent for explosives.
If there's a van I want to get.
You just going to load the van up and then park it by the...
If there's a van I want to blow up.
Why do you want to blow up a van?
In it.
Oh, I see what you're committed to in it.
I just wanted to see how much it's going to cost.
I'll find out.
All the gun purchases had taken place on Skin's turf, but this new plan changed the situation. To protect their agent, the ATF set up a bogus apartment, fully wired with surveillance equipment to use for all future deals. In the flat next door would be armed ATF agents.
Okay, that's what you're talking about. Yeah, this is just the one that I think it's $50.
I'm purchasing a sawed-off shotgun and an ounce of methamphetamine from Jason Hawthorne.
In the apartment, the weapons sales slowed and the van plot was shelved for lack of money. But Skin revealed yet another criminal plan.
Skin asking me if I knew of places that he could burglarize.
Skin had run out of weapons and planned a robbery. With the potential for violence and with innocent lives at risk, the ATF quickly devised a strategy to end his criminal activity.
We can't allow him to continue to do these burglaries.
Cool, that looks good too, looks really good.
Skin targeted a house to burgle that he believed had plenty of guns and narcotics. the undercover agent pretended to go along with the scheme.
Oh, okay, cool. Yeah.
So a plan was developed so we could take them down all together.
The ATF prepared to arrest the gang on the night of the robbery. The gang met in the agent's apartment.
They're dressed in full SWAT gear. They have their firearms, their black masks, and they believe that they were getting ready to go do a robbery of an individual who had a large amount of narcotics. They were nervous. You can see them smoking methamphetamine. You see skin, the table, devising the plan on who was going to be where, who was going to duct tape the individuals inside the home.
The undercover agent suddenly received an unexpected phone call from his backup team.
What up, man? I got you. We're going. Bye.
My boss called me and advised the wire was down.
The undercover agent was on his own.
It did take things to a different level because my rescue team wouldn't be able to hear what was going on if something went bad.
If the agent's camera was seen by the gang or his cover was blown, he'd have to contend with a dangerous mix of meth, adrenaline, and white supremacists alone.
This was the climax of the investigation, probably the most dangerous part of the investigation, too. Three of the four had been smoking methamphetamines. They all had guns on them. As I'm driving them to the location, my wire is still down. They were amped up, thinking they were going to do a robbery. So it was a very intense moment.
Cut off from his backup team, the undercover agent knew that any mistake on his part could get him killed.
The plan was for me to drive to a secure location where a takedown team was waiting for them.
The gang was poised to strike, but there was no place to rob. All that was waiting for them were heavily armed SWAT team and ATF agents. As seen in this exclusive ATF footage, the gang offered little resistance to the arresting team. In the face of the indisputable video evidence against him, Skin pleaded guilty and was sentenced, along with the other seven crew members.
Skin received a 34-year prison sentence for narcotics trafficking and firearms trafficking. It was combined 147 years prison time for the eight crew members. We took at least 20 guns off the streets. I don't know how you would put a number on the amount of guns that we stopped from putting on the streets by getting this crew behind bars.